Chapter 6. He went back in the house to find Ava in the kitchen, pouring Jim Beam. Ava in a tank top and shorts, her hair wrapped in a towel that was like a white turban around her head. She said, "Who was that?" not sounding too interested. And he told her and she said, "Oh, the one with the Heil Hitler on his chest? He was one of Bowman's buddies. He came to take you someplace. Most likely to see Boyd. You want something with yours? I got Diet Coca-Cola, RC Cola, Dr. Pepper. Just ice, if you have some." I ever forget to fill the trays. Bowman starts slapping me. "What's wrong with you? Don't you know how to keep house?" The towel covering her hair made the rest of her seem more exposed. White and kind of puffy. More to her. Like she'd gained a good 20 pounds since taking off the house dress that hung on her. He now saw it was that wild hair that had made her face appear drawn. He noticed bruises on her pale skin, on her arms and legs, that made her appear soiled and, oh man, her behind filled out those shorts. Raylan watching her carrying their drinks to the table, where she'd shot her husband. "I cleaned it up good. Had to scrub the wall there with Lysol to get, you know, the stains off it. I think Lysol's the best cleaning product you can buy." Raylan sat down at the table with her. "You haven't seen Boyd, have you? I mean, since?" "No, but he'll be after me, I know. He's been after me." "That's why we want to keep an eye on you," Raylan said. "You know I'm with the Marshal Service?" "I believe it was your mother told me, before she passed." Ava lit a cigarette from a pack lying on the table and blew a stream of smoke by him. "I made the mistake of telling Bowman about his brother coming around and he whipped me with his belt. Didn't want to believe it." She drew on the cigarette again, smoke coming out as she said, "Here's a man was so jealous, he stopped by Betty's to check on me." "Betty's? Hair salon, where I work, or did. I trained under Betty, washing hair, giving perms. I do hair now for special occasions, weddings, graduations. I do a bunch of the girls. Yeah, Bowman would stop by and look in. He'd get on me for the least thing. Like if he found a hair in his bait possum, or I didn't get out all the scent glands. He'd have a fit. Throw a supper at me, the plate, the whole mess." Raylan listened, sipping his drink, wanting to get back to Boyd. "I wish I could move. Go someplace and open my own hair salon." "Where do you live?"
"West Palm Beach."
"Is it nice?"
"Palm trees and traffic, if you're going anywhere."
Ava drew on a cigarette and started to grin. She turned it off, exhaling the smoke, and said, "I think Bolin's problem, besides being stupid, he wasn't raised properly. He had the worst table manners. Like, he'd be sitting here, he'd lean over to one side and get a look like he was concentrating on some deep thought, furrow his brow, and let out a fart. It didn't matter he was having his supper. But the worst, oh my lord, were the beer farts. Next morning when he was hungover, I'd have to leave the house." Raylan managed to smile, nodding his head. "That's the way he always was. Either drunk or hungover, or gone. Off playing soldier with his brother."
"You have any idea where he is?"
Ava looked at him funny. "I imagine he's in hell. Where else would he be?" "I mean Boyd."
"Boyd's on his way there. You gonna arrest him?"
"Have to catch him in the act first. Robbing a bank, blowing up a church. Making an attempt on your life."
"Mine?"
"You said yourself he'd be coming after you."
"'Cause he likes me.
Boyd don't want to shoot me, Raylan. He wants to..." She shrugged in a cute way. "Go to bed with me?" Ava stubbed out her cigarette, her eyes warm as she looked at him and put a hand on his.
"You want me to help you catch him?"
Raylan sipped his drink.
"How about if you get him to talk to me?"
"I could do that." Ava got up and Raylan's gaze followed her into the kitchen. He said, "I hear he has a place up by Suki Ridge." Then had to wait for Ava to come back to the table with Jim Beam and a bowl of ice.
"It's his church," Ava said, freshening their drinks. "He's only there when he gets his skinheads together. There's a fun bunch. They sit around drinking beer and listening to black hater bands. Different ones like Midtown Boot Boys, Dying Breed, all bopping the bald heads. They are so creepy."
"Boyd doesn't stay there?"
"Bowman said he has places around that nobody knows about. Not even all the skins."
Ava took a drink and said, said Dano of Worm, giving Relland a sly look with those brown eyes he remembered. It was Boyd, not Bowman. Told me where he stays most of the time. Rayland took a drink. You want to tell me where it is? Ava said. And what do I get if I do?
In the deep dark hills of eastern Kentucky.